Like me, you don't want to spend a ton of money doing it. Designer Howard Easton is here to show us some DIY projects for spring. Howard, always nice to see you.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Always nice to see you.
Spring colors.
Yes, you too.
Thank you.
Looks nice.
So metallic is a trend for spring.
It is. So metallics, I kind of introduced golds and silvers before, mm-hmm. but I'm introducing everything. That's the trend for this spring and summer.
Okay.
So if you look at this, what I've done is painted out and to use the recycle and reuse method.
Uh-huh.
I've used old pasta jars, mason jars, things
wow.
like that, just to paint it out to give you a metallic look. And just blending metallics is the uh-huh. trend as well. So you want to make sure that you cluster these together and see it makes a really great arrangement.
It really does. Oh, I never would have thought of that. Old mason jars.
Yeah. And then also, you can also introduce it into your bookcases as well, right?
Oh.
So you can get scrapbooking paper that uh-huh. has metallic finishes on it. You can stack them up. It makes it look a lot lighter,
mm-hmm.
a lot more airy. And then also, you can just put it on the edge, use some cardboard or either some paper bags.
Yeah.
That's another reused product.
Okay.
And we're recycling all the time. Yeah.
That is an amazing idea. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's talk about our artwork. You have some great examples right here of how you can freshen up the artwork for spring.
Yes, and you know, artwork can be very expensive. So, I mean, I suggest switching it out every now and then,
mm-hmm.
but that can be expensive as well. But one thing that I came up with, which is conversational, right,
okay.
is this look here with the comic book paper with cartoons in the Sunday newspaper.
Uh-huh.
So here what I've done is created a conversational piece. This is good for bathrooms, for living spaces, just to create that conversation because it might be a funny cartoon that you like to share. So, and it's easy, and it has spring colors in it. You know, those ads always have those spring colors.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, so.
And let's talk about this trend. You did this piece yourself. I see your signature down there.
Yeah. So if you do something custom, you always want to sign it to make it look professional.
Mm-hmm.
So this one is a recycle reuse product as well. What we use is bottles. So basically the imprint that you see there is using just a regular soda bottle. And at the bottom, you'll see the 5-point impression
uh-huh.
here. You just dip it in paint as I have here,
uh-huh.
and then you can make your impression.
Neat.
To make the center mark, you can just also use the top.
Wow, you painted that with the gold.
Yes, absolutely. So you just dip that in and also make an impression on your artwork. So you have easy, recyclable, reusable products in your own home that you can use.
I just can't get enough. And
yeah.
look at this rug. Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
So brighten up your entryways. So if you have that boring brown mat in front of
yeah.
your doorway, you can use the same thing. Here's what I've done with this is just to use some painter's tape to make the stripes,
mm-hmm.
and I use spring colors, and also use those same impressions on the on the doormat to give it a spring
yeah.
look and feel.
So that orange and yellow that we see there using that same bottle.
Yeah, and notice that I'm using the same trends of color. So this palette has continuity throughout the house.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I love it. Okay, tell me what we have down here.
All right, so also you can make functional art as well. So instead of getting rid of your old utensils down here, you can spray paint them. So if they're damaged, if they're tarnished, you can always make a message center with them. So what I've done is use some old scrap wood,
mm-hmm.
and I've actually glued these. You can glue or either you can screw them in, but
okay.
I glued them here, and you just paint them out, and it makes the best message center for
Look
your kitchen.
Because we always use the refrigerator.
Yeah. So it keeps the clutter away from the refrigerator, is on the wall, is artistic, and is really unique.
Okay.
So a second thing is your larger utensils as well. So here we have like a big...
So
what I've done is bend it so that it can actually accommodate a candle and not just added a bow to make it look a little bit more special and unique. So,
okay, so we're going to show how you can stick the candle in there.
Yeah, so you just
drop it in.
Add that in there.
Look
and
at
see,
that.
Perfect. You have a votive candle that you can add in there, and it creates a very interesting piece. Now, this is for your kitchen, your outdoor, so it can work indoor or outdoor. Just use indoor or outdoor paint accordingly.
Okay, Howard, these are great ideas. I always love when you stop by. Thank you so much for sharing.
Yes, my pleasure. My pleasure always. And happy spring.
Yes, happy spring.
Yeah.
Of course, Howard's ideas are designed to be DIY, but if you just don't have the time, Howard can do it for you. Check out his website at hedesignsonline.com. And from DIY to what the experts showed off at the High Point Furniture Market a few weeks